Take it out. Hesperia, Florida, check yourselves out! Yeah. I'm here on Speedwagon and Cheap Trick in a full arena in Florida. It don't get much better than that, baby. Man, we go so far back with Cheap Trick, man. You know, we're both originally Illinois bands. And, and we love those boys, man. We have a good time. You know, when you're going to be out on the road for a long time, you don't want to be messing around with people that you don't like to hang with. The guys in Cheap Trick, what you see on stage is what you get. I love those boys. One of the great American rock and roll bands of all time. So, you know, this is the last show of our spring tour. Then we get a little bit of time off. So it kind of makes you reflect about, you know, what you're doing out here and how you miss the people at home, your friends and your family. And you know, part of the deal of being on the road is you've got to be able to survive being out here, right? So what I've learned over my 73 years on this planet try to wake up every morning, put one foot in front of the other, and do my best to live every moment. Thank you. So, you know, there was an old trick that we all used to use back in the days when bands made albums. And what we did is we figured that, you know, back in those days you had to get up and turn the record over if you wanted to hear side two. And we figured that by the time the end of side one came, some people would be too wasted to actually get up and make the move to turn it over. So we were smart. We tried to put all of our favorite songs on side one, but then we made an album in 1981 called High Infidelity. And we had just hit like a mother load of creativity at that time. We had too many songs. So we're gonna play a few of those songs right now from side two that you may have been too stoned to hear.
Truth and peace. She goes.
guys. Ladies and gentlemen, fresh off the road with Elton John for 12 years on the bass guitar, playing his ass off, Mr. Matt Bissonette.
My knee out, I need surgery, I'm going good.
Woo! Matt went from a chartered jet to a tour bus overnight.
Yeah!
And from what I understand, tour bus aren't so bad.
I like you, Kevin.
Anyway, this next one is the closing song on the High Infidelity album. It's called I Wish You Were There.
You can go.
song right now. You know, all songwriters have that bunch of songs that you write that are okay, you know, you're trying to find your voice, you know, trying to figure out how to really do it. And then all of a sudden one day, you write a song and you kind of go, kind of surprise yourself. You're like, whoa, that actually sounds like a real song. And so we're gonna play right now that song for me, and it ended up being the tune that I played for the guys in REO Speedwagon back in 1972 that got me the gig. And before I knew it, I was on my way to Nashville to record REO TWO back in 1972, and this song was on the record. It's called Music Man. To my left, on lead guitar, from Framingham, Massachusetts, Dave Amato! For the last 35 years, Dave has been walking out here every night, kicking ass, rocking hard, always with a great attitude. Let's hear it for Davey. Matter of fact, the dude who introduced me to Dave back in 1989 told me about him, told me about his playing and his singing and all his musicality. But the thing that really did the trick was when he told me that Dave is the kind of guy who would help you move. And I'm like, wait a minute, my apartment's getting kind of small. I could probably use to move somewhere. Who? Dave! Well, if you could. There's a chair in my dressing room that's in a little...
I bet I get it now.
Dave Amato, everybody!
Dave Amato!
Now, when Dave joined us back in 89, he did have some mighty big shoes to fill. Shoes that were previously occupied by my great old friend, co-writer, co-producer, the original lead guitar player in REO Speedwagon, the late, great Gary Rittrin. Oh yeah. Now Gary left this world prematurely to say the least, but I will tell you what, his spirit lives on every time we walk out on stage. And wherever his spirit may be in the universe right now, I know that he's looking right down at this room in Estero, Florida, saying, y'all better have a good time tonight. So this next one is another one from the early 70s, from our bar band days. It's pretty much Gary's 5-minute autobiography, a song called Son of a Poor Man. Hometown lady, leaving father's city, betting him she bought him a chair. As he looked through the window, saw her eyes were as red as mine. Wake up, Bob, but I can't believe she's leaving. Oh, but a woman can't be helpless in a lonely farmer's town. In the sun of Palmy, ain't gonna turn your head around.
Good. Awesome,
if you ever get lonely, you just pick up the telephone. Oh, yeah. Yes, my guitar tech, Polly, knows how to put the herbal in herbal tea.
Herbal.
No, I'm kidding.
You're not.
Not really. So, a few years back, we were in need of a keyboard player. And, you know, when you're looking for a musician in a band, you call your musician friends. And so we put some calls out this way and that way. I finally called my old buddy Rick Springfield. Right? We like to work with Rick. And Rick tells me, Casey, stop your searching. I got your man. He plays a great Hammond B3 organ, an amazing piano. He's an awesome harmony singer. And probably most importantly to me, he is a fine, sweet, decent human being. So ladies and gentlemen, if you will, say hello to the happiest man in rock and roll on the piano, Derek Hilland.
And I can't close all that I ever thought.
The lyric was an anti-war anthem, and we were living on campus at the University of Illinois in Champaign, and the students kind of gravitated toward it, and it was really the first song that connected us with the campus. But the great thing about music is that as the years go by, we grow, we change, hopefully we get a little bit wiser, we get our ideas about stuff changes, and so now, when we play this song, we're thinking about the brave young men and women all around the world that are stationed there, risking their lives so that we can be here tonight having a big old rock and roll party. Tell you is that I myself, everyone up here, and I imagine the majority of y'all out there are proud to have been born and raised in the land of the free, the home of the brave, right here in the Golden Country.
You, my friend, come out of this ugliness, we must pull it in.
With iron money, you poor can be fed. You start around and you flirt with disaster. You never really care just to what comes after. Your back's a die, but your back is still curved. And your freaks are crying, but your back is still turned. Better stop your hiding, or your country will burn.
Feeling the love is gone. I do believe it, I've had enough.
Thank you so much. We appreciate that West Coast of Florida hospitality. So, this next one is the song that changed everything.
Thank you.
Bissonette on the bass guitar for you tonight. Derek Hilland on the keyboards. Dave Amato on lead guitar. The Hitman, Brian Hitt on the drums. Thanks again to our buddies Cheap Trick. We got the greatest road crew in rock and roll. I'm Kevin Cronin. We're REO Speedwagon. Thanks for having us, Escaro. Let's do it again soon, all right?